Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate the use of this re-evaluate workflow rule after field change. So I am going to demonstrate you how it works in workflow rules. Meanwhile, you can see how you can watch Salesforce training videos. So you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So now coming on to the topic. So here you can see I have created one workflow rule, and that is updating a field, a lead source. So I created this workflow rule or on contact object. So whenever I create or update any contact record, so this lead source field will be updated and its value will be web, right? And right now this re-evaluate workflow rule after field change is unchecked, right? So let's understand what is this. So with the help of this help text, you can read this description. If this field update changes the field's value, all workflow rules on the associated object are re-evaluated. Any workflow rule whose criteria are met as a result of the field update will be triggered, right? So after this workflow rule will be fired, so lead source value will be web. So I have one more workflow rule where rule criteria is if contact lead source equals to web, then this workflow rule will be triggered and it will send an email alert, right? So now we want to make these two workflow rule as dependent. Like if this is fired, then this should be fired. So right now this checkbox is unchecked, so that we can test it whether it is working or not. So I'm opening my university app. So let's see its rule criteria so that we can fill the values accordingly. So its rule criteria is that email should contain @gmail.com. And it will be fired when record is created or anytime it's edited to subsequently meet criteria, right? So let's see what happens when this rule is triggered, whether a second rule will trigger or not. So I'm creating new contact. So test. Evaluate one, then here I am filling my email address and lead sources right now none. So whenever I will be clicking on save, so this record will be created and you will see lead source will be set web automatically. So I'm clicking on save, record is created, I'm moving to details. And here you can see lead sources web automatically. Let's check my email box. So here you can see no email is available. This is the existing one. So I'm just deleting this one. So you saw I created one record where I filled the email and this rule triggered and it updated the field as a lead source as web, but this didn't work because we didn't check the checkbox. So now I'm going to click on edit and I'm selecting this and clicking on save. So now if we create a record and put email that contains @gmail, so @gmail.com, so this lead source field will be updated, its value will be web. Then this workflow rule will be triggered and it will send an email that is associated with this email alert. So now I'm going to create one more record. So name is test re-evaluate 2. Now I am putting email address. And clicking on save, so you will see So it is showing duplicate error. So I'm changing last name, clicking on save. Okay, so it is not allowing me. Yeah, I'm changing this name again. Test the evaluate. So this time it is created. You can see lead sources web. And now if we check our email, so you can see here email is available. So it is sending this congratulation email, which is associated with this workflow rule, right? And this email is because of another workflow rule. So another workflow rule is creating a task. So let me show you so that you can understand. So I have one more workflow rule that is also having same rule criteria, that is lead source is equals to web, and it is creating a task. So that's why this second email is related to that. So task is created and it is assigned to Vikas, and priority, due date, subject, comments, all these things are available. And if you see, you can see on activities, the task related details are available. So you can see I created a record and put email having @gmail.com. This rule updated a field lead source as web. And on that lead source field, we have two workflow rules where rule criteria is batching. One is create task for contact, and another one is send email alerts. So both are working because we checked that checkbox that we evaluate rule criteria. So this was the second one. It is also having same rule criteria. So if we go again here, so here you can see this checkbox is checked right now. So friends, if your multiple workflow rules are interdependent, like if you are firing one workflow rule and that is setting, that is updating a particular field value, and based on that field, your another workflow rule are firing, or you can say the updated field is the part of your rule criteria of another workflow rules, and you want to execute them in a row. So you can check this checkbox as true so that it can be made happen. So you can test it in your org so that you can understand how it is working. If you have any question, you can send me an email so that you can discuss this with me. And if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name, Sanjay Gupta, on YouTube, and you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.